And good evening. Thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. Governor LePage said in his State of the State speech that it was his mission to end domestic violence here in Maine. And he is holding true to that promise today by declaring February Teen Dating Violence Awareness Month. News 8's Cam Tran is live in our studios with more on what LePage is doing to end domestic violence. Cam?
Well, Tracy, in addition to that announcement, the governor also unveiled a new public service announcement which sends a message to Mainers, especially men, that domestic violence is not tolerated here in Maine.
With this signature, Governor Paul LePage declared February Teen Dating Violence Awareness and Prevention Month.
Sign this proclamation with all my blood and energy towards helping the state of Maine rid itself of all form of domestic violence.
The governor's bold statement and declaration today are words Jill Barkley with the Maine Coalition to End Domestic Violence supports.
As well, we know adults are impacted by domestic violence, we also know that there can be abusive relationships in high school and middle school.
According to Barkley, one out of 14 relationships will have some type of abuse, whether it's emotional, physical, or sexual. To end those statistics, Governor LePage is taking his mission to the television screen.
I'm calling on you to join me to stand up against domestic abuse.
The governor partnered with the coalition to create this new public service announcement set to air soon. The announcement features domestic violence victims in Maine and calls on Mainers, especially men, to take a stance against abuse.
I think it's unusual for a governor to take such a strong stand and to make this his number one social issue. We're thrilled to have the governor's support and especially his leadership around encouraging men to stand up, because though most domestic violence is perpetrated by men, most men are not abusive.
The ad features a statewide domestic violence hotline for victims to find help and for people to report what they think is abuse.
The governor is also working with the coalition to introduce a bill that would make bail conditions tougher for domestic violence offenders, and another bill which could make strangulation a stiffer charge. Live in the newsroom, Cam Fran, News 8.